best reasons actually to live in your car is because then you're not anchored to the view, which might be, what, your next door, the backside of your next door neighbor's house? You know, I would much rather be able to change my view all the time and have my view be this, you know? To me, that's much more interesting. That's much more, that's just living a richer life in my book. Even though my car is old and it doesn't look great, the thing is, I get 43 miles per gallon in my car. And my car's a 1997 model. I cannot buy a new car that is guaranteed to get me better gas mileage than I already get. Even if I were to buy a hybrid, if I was to go buy a Toyota Prius, I know people here in Boulder that get mid-30s out of their Prius. That's a choice. I'd like to get a newer car. I can afford a newer car, but I don't want to, you know, burn all that extra gas. To me, that's an ecological decision. There is such a misconception in America that if you are living in your car, then you are poor. And that, I mean, I'm definitely not a wealthy man, don't get me wrong. You know, I make an average income for, you know, an American household. But I'm able to do things that other people can't because I choose to live this lifestyle rather than spending it on housing. And it's by choice. When I go on a road trip, I'll usually carry a firearm. But that's just because I'll be in unfamiliar places and I'll never know where I'm going to end up for the night. I've ended up in some fairly unsavory places when, you know, I got too tired to keep driving. And, you know, not that I felt like I was going to get attacked or anything, but it's just a, just in case, that I've stayed in. Seattle, Washington. While Seattle overall is a pretty safe city, but the areas where people such as myself gather in order to, there's streets in Seattle where there's car, and you just walk down the street and everybody's sleeping in their car at night. And in those areas, there's lots of gang activity because they're in somewhat, you know, more crime-ridden areas of the. And the reason for that is because it's illegal to sleep in your car, so if you want to avoid the police, you're going to go to the places where the police don't go. So it's a catch-22. But this is how I live. This board right here,
yeah.
I pop that off, and that is actually the board that goes in the passenger seat.
Yeah.
And I just take all this stuff and I shove it further down.
Some of which comes with you to go on top
correct,
of the board.
Correct. Because that you can tell that's the bedroll.
Yeah. Very comfortable.
Blankets.
Yeah.
Pillows. I mean, so yeah. Mm. A good chunk of that stuff actually comes in the car with me.
Yeah.
And I told you earlier how I like everything containerized into stuff I can just grab. Duffel bag full of clothes. Obviously, I've got that. This is my closet. Mm-hmm. I just grab stuff and put it on that rack in the back of the car.
Yeah.
Each box or bin that you see is very specific items. For example, the brown and black bag right there, that is all, you know, toiletries and cologne, shampoo, cotton swabs, whatever.